Dear students, we were discussing Microsoft Word and this is our part 2 for text group discussions. So in today's topic, we will cover drop cap, objects, equations and symbols. So let's start the practical. So here we are in the insert group and we are over here the text group part 2. And we are going to start from drop cap. So drop cap option you might have seen in the start of the book or in the book chapters. So one of the initial character is being made with high fonts. So for example, if you click on this and you go over here and if you click on drop, so you can see that the first character of this paragraph has been made with a bigger font, but that bigger font has been adjusted in a nice way. So another way could be that if you do not use the drop cap option and you click over here and let's try to make it with bigger font, so then you can see the difference. So for example, if I say I want to make it of 72 point size. So then you can see that all of the text has been pushed downwards. So only one line is aligned with the first character and other text has been pushed down. But if we press Ctrl Z to reverse ourselves, to undo, and then if you go again on the insert and click on the drop cap, so then you can see that it has been done nicely. So the next option is you have this signature line which you can add. You can add date and time wherever you want. For example, if you are over here and you want to add date and time in this fashion, so you can see that this date has been inserted over here. And then you can also add objects. So if you click on this, so then you will be given different kind of objects which you can add anywhere in this text. So for example, if I move over here, insert object, and let's say I want to add a Microsoft PowerPoint slide. So if I click over it, then you can see I am given a Microsoft PowerPoint slide where I can add whatever I want. So for example, if I add hello and let's say I put it like this, save, and then if I go, so then you can see that this has been entered on the page where I was working. So on the same document, it has been inserted. So this is the external object. So I'm going to delete it. So you can add such objects wherever you want from the list of objects available over here. So you can see different kind of objects are available. And then the last thing is the symbols and equations. So there are many different type of symbols which are not available on the keyboard you are using, but you want to add such a symbol. So for example, if I want to add over here the symbol, I will go into this one, and there are different kind of symbols which will be shown to me. So for example, if I want to add this symbol, so I will just click on it, insert this symbol, click on it, insert. So there are variety of symbols which I can add, and such symbols are not available in the keyboard. So you can see these symbols have been inserted in line with the text. And then the last thing is the equation. So whenever you are going to write any mathematical equation, so you need to go over here, select this tab. And then there are some pre-compiled and pre-written equations which you can add. For example, you can add this equation. So you can see that the equation has been added in your document, which are will be nicely written. So if you want to add another equation, again go on to the insert, symbol, equation, and if your equation is not the one which are available over here, so you can add insert new equation, then you can type whatever you want here. So this would be acting as equation, and you can of course add any symbol wherever you want. So for example, you can add this symbol as well. So whatever you want, you can add in this equation. So this is basically the end of insert ribbon and the text group. So dear students, let's summarize today's module. We have experimented on remaining options in the text group of insert ribbon and symbol group.